So all of our kids, the Bible says, do not compare yourselves among yourselves. Don't ever ask your kid, why aren't you like your sister? You ought to be like your brother. They're not their sister and they're not their brother. Every kid comes out different. I mean, I'll be honest with you. I thought when Jessica was born, I told me, they made a mistake at the hospital. This is not our kid. Because, you know, your first kid is like it's a guinea pig. You're learning. Like, oh, dear God. And about the time you learn how to raise a five-year-old, they turn six. And about the time you run to 6-year-old, they turn seven. You're chasing the first one. I'm sorry. I did the best I could. And you wait on the second one. Now I'm ready. I'm ready to be a parent. And the second one's born, and they're nothing like the first. There's no way. That's my kid. They came out different. Because God's a very creative God. You know, he made a peacock. You know, God made a baboon with a fluorescent pink rump. You ever think what God was thinking that day he made the animal kingdom? Yeah, big monkey, little monkey, fat monkey, hairy monkey. Oh, hey, you come back here. I'm looking forward to answering. And after he said, no, come back here. And then he sprayed it pink. There you go. You're not going to get lost, I'll tell you that. Well, if God did that with the animal kingdom, what do you think he'd do with us? No two people are the same. Our thumbprints aren't the same. Our voice prints aren't the same. God is a creative God. And so all of our kids come out different. So don't ever compare your children among them. They are different. Sarah could make an A without opening a book. Jessica would struggle to get that same A. Both went to the same university on scholarship. Sarah went on an academic scholarship. Jessica went on a basketball scholarship. Your gift, not your sister's gift, not your brother's gift, not your daddy's gift, your gift will make room for you. Each kid comes out different. Their gifts are different, but their gift will make room for them. My job as a parent is to help them develop that gift. Because there's the devil trying to steal it and stop it and thwart it and pervert it. So it's like, I got to teach kids two things in the Word of God. You got to learn how to repent quick and forgive quick. There's nobody sin free. And the devil wants to make you feel really bad. He's the accuser of the brethren. So one of the greatest things you learn from the Word of God as a child is if you sin, repent quick. Spit the dirt out of your mouth. Repent to God. Get back up. Get your hand back on the plow and start moving again. You can't let sin stop you. Repent or forgive, get up. Well, I knew that. Yes, you did. You're a doofus. Everybody's sinned. We've all been stupid at some point. The Bible says the righteous fall seven times a day, but they get back up. We're not the perfect people. We're the getting back up people.